Have you wondered how wireless chargers work? Let us see how it works. But before that, let us go through some basics. We will start with what is electricity. Electricity is just directional flow of electrons. That is, electrons move from one atom to other in a particular direction as shown here. And any wire in which electric current is flowing is surrounded by an invisible force field called magnetic field, shown by the circular arrows. So, basically, electromagnetism is production of magnetic field by a current flowing in a conductor. Now, Faraday said that when electrons flow through a conductor, magnetic field is created. Similarly, he also proved that when you move a magnet near a conductor, that is actually you are changing the magnetic field, then the current will be generated in the conductor. Here, moving the magnet is changing the magnetic field and hence current is generated. As a result, the lights are glowing. How did this current appear from nowhere? Current is produced in the conductor because the magnetic lines of force of the magnet are applying a force on the free electrons of the conductor and causing them to move. That is, flow of electrons, which is electricity. So, in short, if you change the magnetic field, current is generated, and flow of electron in a conductor causes a magnetic field around it. Now, why are the conductors or these wires always coiled around? Because coiling increases the field strength. You might also know the difference between AC and DC. In DC, the current does not oscillate. Why? In AC, it does. That is, in AC, the electrons continuously move back and forth, which is like if the frequency is 50 Hz, then they move 50 times back and forth in 1 second. Then how are the appliances running in AC? It is like this. The bulb is glowing even though the supply is AC. That is, the electrons are moving back and forth. Now, when this AC current is passed through a conductor, then the electromagnetic field produced is constantly growing and shrinking as the current is AC. This growing and shrinking of magnetic field acts as a changing magnetic field to another conductor placed near it. You know, changing magnetic field produces current, and the current is generated in the other conductor, and hence the lamp B is glowing. Here, electricity got transferred wirelessly. This is known as induction. The same concept is used in wireless chargers. The wireless charger has an induction coil, and the mobile phone also has an induction coil below the battery. Then you have the circuit board of the phone and the screen. Now, a high frequency changing supply is given to the induction coil in the wireless charger. And when you place the coil in the phone near the coil in the charger, that is, phone on top of the charger, then current will be induced in the coil of the phone and transferred to the battery. The wireless charger can have more than one coil like this, or up to 7 coils to increase the strength and the coverage area. The coil in the mobile looks like this, and as a whole, they function like a transmitter and receiver circuit as shown here. Now, both the coils should be close to each other for induction to take place. Hence, you need to keep the phone in a particular angle, and while buying cover for such phones, take care that the cover is not too thick, as thick covers will increase the distance between the coil and affect the induction. There are various wireless standards like Qi, which is written QI but pronounced as Qi of WPC. PMA and Alliance for Wireless Power have clubbed together to form Air Fuel Alliance. The difference between these standards are the transmission frequencies and connection protocols used to communicate with the devices. Apple uses only Qi in iPhones, while other phones may use both. The technology used by WPC is inductive, while Alliance for Wireless Power uses resonant as well. Let us switch to inductive and resonant. Inductive is what we were discussing till now, where base station is the charger and the mobile is the receiver. Base station receives power from the external source and the system unit sends it to the power conversion unit, which has the primary coil, and the whole unit is the transmitter. The receiver has a power pickup unit with secondary coil. And both of them have communication and control unit. You can keep more than one device as there is more than one primary coil unit. In resonant, the advantage is that you can maintain a slight distance between the charger and the phone. The phone need not be placed at a particular angle on top of it. Resonant is similar to induction. Here, the frequency is tuned to get the maximum power transfer, and this frequency is known as resonant frequency. The transmitter and receiver both operate in this frequency. Resonant is more convenient as you can place the device in any orientation, but inductive is more efficient. Wireless charging versus wired charging. What do you think? Which is better? When compared with wired charging by USB-C cable and USB-C charger, wireless charging is definitely slower. Even when we are talking about fast wireless charging, it is not available on all phones, and so you have to take into consideration what phone you are using and also what charger you are using. Wireless charging heats up your phone, which affects the battery life. So, for now, if you want fast charging, go for wired USB-C cables and charger. Or if you want comfort, use wireless chargers, preferably like overnight chargers. But tech keeps on evolving and you will find faster wireless chargers coming out soon.